Good evening, everybody. Meteorologist Alexis Hermanson here in the TV6 Forecast Center. Wanted to give you an update. We do have a first alert day in effect for tomorrow. As of right now, hopefully you were able to enjoy Saturday. 67 degrees is the current temperature right now, and overnight, we are going to keep seeing those temperatures drop to about the low 60s here in the Quad Cities. And we are going to see an increase in clouds, as well as an increase in rain chances. Here's what we're looking at for the rest of your Labor Day weekend. First alert day for some strong to severe storms that are expected into Sunday. We also have two chances for rain on Sunday. That's going to start overnight, then we'll have a break, and then we'll have another chance later on into the evening. But at least the rain cooled air going to stick around. We're going to see cooler temperatures into Labor Day and, yes, to even continue through the next work week. So, as I was saying, here's our best chance for rain. Really early morning before 9 a.m., that's when we're going to see our best shot in the Quad Cities for some rain. So, yes, you are going to hear a few rumbles of thunder into the overnight hours before we have some dry time late morning, early afternoon. But doesn't mean it's going to be comfortable. We'll take a look at that in a second. And then we're going to have another chance for some scattered showers and storms to develop by later on Sunday evening. Now, tomorrow, again, as I said, we are going to have our dry time into the afternoon. Doesn't mean it'll be comfortable. It's going to be a little bit muggy out there, as well as pretty windy. 15 to 25 mile per hour sustained winds. We could see wind gusts nearing 40. Not really going to be the best time to get the picnic on, anything of the sort. Just going to be a little bit too windy for that. And again, those rain chances will rise later on into the evening. And temperatures, though, into the afternoon, going to be pretty warm. We're going to reach close to 90 degrees into the afternoon, thanks to a warm front that's been lifting by tomorrow. And as we take a look, here's our storm risk for severe storms. As you're seeing, the Quad Cities, the farther north and east that you go, we're under a slight risk. That's level 2 out of 5. And into the morning, we have a threat for strong winds as well as large hail. And we could see brief heavy rain at times, but the good news is that with the storms, they are expected to be moving fast. So at least we are looking at a large flash flood threat, but still something to be aware of. We could see that brief period of heavy rain. And later on into the evening, that's when we have a chance, about a 2% chance for a tornado. So really just an isolated tornado threat is going to be possible with our round of evening storms. So let's track it all out for us. As you're seeing, before 5 a.m., it'll reach our northernmost counties. It will be in the Quad Cities before 8. And before you know it, by the late morning, that's when we're going to see our dry time. Again, remember, partly cloudy skies, but it will be pretty windy out there as we head into Sunday afternoon. And as a cold front moves through the area, that's when we could see the redevelopment of scattered showers and storms. As you're seeing here, could even near about midnight. So again, as you're heading into bed on Sunday night, could hear some of those storms roam through. And you're even seeing that we will be mostly dry here by the time we reach early on Monday morning, really 1-2 in the morning. Then we're going to clear things out and see mostly clear skies to start us out on Monday morning, really Labor Day morning for us. And again, one more time, the cold front going to do a good job, because first off, we have our warm front that's going to give us some moisture tomorrow. That's going to rise our dew points yet again. Pretty humid out there, about 65 to 70 degrees by the time we get our cold front going through, and of course the rain as well. Really going to be pleasant into Labor Day. Another good shot at taking some outdoor activities on Monday. Now, we'll have rain chances through most of the week. As we're talking about Labor Day for a moment, expect that into the late evening. So really, just any afternoon activities going to be good. May see a few clouds, but again, we're waiting on the Monday rain until later on into the evening. And as we're taking a look at our precipitation outlook, it is looking favorable for better rain chances and some cooler temperatures. Yes, very cool next to Monday through Friday. Here's a check on all of our temperatures and rain chances, as they're going to be present for most of the week. And for temperatures, going to see, yes, low to mid 60s as our highs Tuesday through Thursday. So prepare for the cold.